Lovecraft. Episode 4. 3, 2, 1, let's... 3, 2, 1, let's go. That was bad. Did your characters say they get clues? No, they fucking don't. They don't give any clues. This game is unforgiving. On any difficulty. I have to find Husha. I mean, even on very easy, well, where it doesn't even kill the character, it just makes you restart the chapter. Or restart from where you died. It's still can't be unforgiving. Oh yeah.
I guess I can get through now, unless it all caves in.
What I've seen with the events is Requiem always requires a large white, a large sized area by the game's categorization. Abyss can happen pretty much anywhere. Silence requires a smaller size room, similar to this one or the next one. Hold the door pretty much can occur anywhere, and hide can occur I think pretty much anywhere, though I suspect it has to be within like a certain space of the a hiding spot. Granted, there's a hiding spot usually every few rooms. The Lovecraft, the worst events to get are the silence, just because it's a horrible, horrible, horrible time. And the hold the door for most characters. Some characters can handle it. But it also hold the door is probably the worst to get from a speedrun aspect, as it locks out a door. And if it's the door you need to get into, well, enjoy waiting a minute. And we have an abyss. Abyss is the ideal one because you can escape it the fastest if your clicking skills are good. And you pay enough attention to make sure you dodge the arm grabs. On some characters like Erica, it is mandatory to dodge the arm grabs.
What's that dirty thing there?
That would have been another goal if it hadn't been for that abyss. Probably would have been about 50 seconds up. Reverse plumber.
After all these years, he's still holding on to the key.
Alright, we got that. Now let's head to Requiem. I think the game tried to do something there, but got shafted. Alright, we got about a 45 second cutscene. Damn, if I'd held it, I would have gotten him too. Alright, we're gonna pass that.
Fuck, were those fucking monks from the Abbey? How is that even possible?
Let's prune some flowers, get the silver key. Good, good. Alright, shovel time. Damn, I didn't. Alright, that's still fine. Bye bye, Iron Key. No, no, no. Stair punish. Plant minigame. Alright, so we have 1, 2, 1, 4, 1, 4, 4, 5, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5, 2. Yep. And then you combine that with the flowers, and you take that over to this. Then you skip this cutscene. And you get deoxidizing solution. By Silver Key. Grab tool part 3. I don't care, ghost. Alright. So, it's the first one. We take this. We pop it down there. And we take this. And we pop it down here. And we take this. We flip it all the way around. Very annoyingly. And drop it there. We take this. And we flip it over. And we drop it there. And we take the cigar cutter looking piece. And we flip it around here. And we drop it. We take this bad boy. Flip it over. Spin it around. Gay little shopper goo. Flip this over. And then slap it all together. Praise be to Cthulhu. Alright, that's done. Now let's go get the first of the ornate keys. Also, by doing a minigame, it actually skips the door event out. Or should. I swear to God if it kills me. Alright, good. Yeah, try not to run into a wall.
I can't believe this.
don't take that back. Alright. Let's go light the well. Do the monster minigame. Almost got stair punished. Alright, that was weird. He just kept balking against my will.
Down there. It should be safe now, I hope.
Yep.
Alright, let's see where this takes me.
Alright, I'm gonna adjust my notes real quick. This is a good point for that. And boom. There we go. Just had to adjust those. This is unskippable, by the way. If that wasn't clear by me rapidly mashing buttons. And we're grabbing it off this back bottom shelf here. So this is actually the fastest route through the sewer. I had a map. I mapped it out. Seeing our friend the tentacle monster.
How am I supposed to get through there?
Alright.
I have to be careful with those levers. I can't let that.
This is why you have to hold it so you can actually see which gate you're interacting with. Otherwise, a lot of people would end up killing themselves in the first time they did this. Actually, I killed 3 characters the first time I did this. Come on, Daniel. Be a bro. Uh-huh. You're stuck. Alright, and he's trapped. And we're free. Well, we're free when we get open this one. Boop.
I have a feeling this is where the cursed concert happened.
I have a feeling you might be right, Daniel. Oh no. Alright, whew. Oh my god, I got them all.
Still here. After all these
Holy
years,
crap. I don't think I've ever actually... That is the first time I've survived the Requiem. Oh, my heart. Oh, my heart. So now we know. If you want to survive the Requiem on H.P. Lovecraft, you have to be able to kill like 10 of those bastards. Got it. My heart is racing. Oh, son of a bitch. Yes, grab the key. Alright, whew.
Bloody hell. Seemed like that thing wanted to grab my hand.
Just wanted to hold your hand, Daniel. Just wanted to hold your hand. In the cutscene, you turn the gear and you lose control, and then something smashes into the floor outside here. And that's where we get key number two. To the graveyard. Ooh.
What the hell? Why did they block this door?
This is a terrifying murder dungeon at the end. Few ones you don't actually have to do a prompt on. He just instinctively goes and breaks into the coffin.
Oh, damn. They murdered him and threw him in here with his key.
Cut skin. Yep.
Oh, whoa, holy shit.
Dang. You can skip that if you manage to keep it out of the view.
What the hell is that?
Huh? And you remember, you have to examine that, find the key in the back, or he will not do it. You do not want to hang out here too long. Your fear meter will progressively get higher and higher and higher. Which means events sooner and sooner and sooner. Oh, no. Dang it, I overshot. Oh, well, that's fine. Alright, this is the... I need to go to... Yep. Come on. Go out. Briefly forgot where I had to go for that.
Screw this. I've got to hide.
Alright, we can do this. All right, we made it.
What the bloody hell just happened?
We do lose a little more time than we normally would since we got it in this room. If we had gotten it in the kitchen, it might have been a little bit better. Because I would have been right next to the table, but we only lose a few seconds having to run across the room and back. Now we have to wait, and wait, and wait.
Oh, bloody nope. Hell. How could I be so stupid?
Just my notes, yoink. Ah, mother. Oh, really, man? Ooh, we made it. Okay.
Christ, that was horrific.
Ah, forgot there's a cart on that one. And I got confused on which door I had to exit. This door. Going to the bunkhouse. Now.
I wonder where those stairs lead to.
You're about to find out, buddy. Yep. Alright, unskippable, but it's not the end of the run. End of the run will be after all the weird.
Pasha has to be in here. It's time to put an end to this nightmare.
Third door, not second door. Alright.
What the hell is happening? Oh god. Mr. Husha? Oh shit. Oh shit, shit, shit. Mr. Husha! Oh, no, 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 no. Sebastian! Oh shit. Fuck. Oh, he's...
Those friends don't make it this far. You have to inspect the corpse of Sebastian to leave, sadly.
What? No. Where the hell am I? Hello? Diary. How goes the Grant? Damn it, another useless lead. Another fucking riddle. I have to get out of here. What the hell?
Maybe it's this one.
Damn it. It won't
nope, happen. Next one. Damn it. Now you gotta get the scare in the mirror.
Holy shit, this can't be happening. I must be seeing things. Oh shit, Dan. Wake the fuck up, man. No way.
I think I went too far. There we go. Oops, damn it. I'll have to retime that a little bit before I submit it.